out in the garage making more of something that's worked very well for me, catching the striper out on the Bay Bridge. This is a 7-inch Wutzit and a 1-ounce jig head. And I'm making them and I'm taking pictures for an article I'm working on for Kayak Angler magazine. But I'm doing some improvements. I'm doing some things that I'm going to let you in on that I think get me more bites while I'm out there on the bay. I've done some glow-in-the-dark plastisol where I mix it in there, and I'm going to do that again. But I'm also going to, instead of using the bare head, I actually got a new fluid bed here, and I'm not going to use that one. I think I'm going to go with the yellow glow-in-the-dark powder paint. So we'll start by filling that in the fluid bed, and I got some of those jig heads that I've made on this mold that does the style 9 heads. It does, this particular Do-It mold has 2.5 ounces and 2 1-ouncers. So you can pour a bunch of those in a hurry. And I did a couple the other night. So we'll use those, and then we'll bake them here in the toaster oven. And then we're gonna go in my porch and we're gonna do a little bit of plastic pouring, and I got some really cool things to show you there. So the first time I ever powder painted something, I actually used a lighter. But I've graduated to using this. It's a little heat gun here. I think they use it for stripping paint. And with an ounce of lead, I'm gonna have to rotate that around a good bit. All right. And then I got my fluid bed here, and all that does is just kind of keeps it fluffed up. And that was hot enough that it stuck right to it. So I'll do a couple of these and stick them in the toaster. And then I'm gonna put some eyeballs on them. I got some 3D eyes, and then something called UV Blast. I'm gonna put a UV based coating on there, and I'll show you with a black light here in a moment what that UV blast is all about. Alright, well, these jig heads are curing. I'm going to take you to the other part of the shop and we're going to make the soft plastic here. The plastic I'm using, and this is the first I've used the hard formula, which is good for salt water. Previously I've added hardener, but I got the good stuff here, so we're gonna give that a shot with some special additives here. This right here, the glow additive, is what's gonna make the these baits work 40 feet down in the Chesapeake Bay. There's not a whole lot of daylight reaching. So we had this powder to the plastisol before we even, and they're different colors. That one's orange. I think I'm gonna use a mixture of the green and blue. Sounds neat, but I'm gonna use green, not aqua, and yellow. And we'll go ahead and put some of that in our bowl with the plastisol. I've already mixed it up, especially the hard formula. You want to get that mixed up real good. And then my additives here, the things I'm gonna add to that are the glow stuff, and we got some chartreuse here. I'm gonna add a little bit of the green chartreuse, something to make it stinky. Make them hold on to it. And then this is holographic silver flake. Just a little bit of glitter in there that, you know, when you're fishing it at the little bit closer to the surface, it's gonna look like a lot of the bait fish that these striper eat. Somewhere in the middle of this, I am going to add rattles. And this is gonna be sort of the tricky part of this. Is I'm going to hand pour part of it first, and then I'm going to put I'm going to pour half of it and then put that rattle in there. Now I'm going to stir this several more times as I heat this up. This hasn't been heated at all. I know from experience that this usually takes, for a bowl that size, which is a lot, should take about 6.5 minutes on this microwave, but I'm not going to do it all at once. I will check it every once in a while and stir it as I need to go. All right, this is that sort of in-between stage where it's not really solid, not really liquid, it's in between, and we're not quite there. This is where you want to mix it really good. Microwaves are interesting because they heat from the inside out, so you can have the middle of this completely liquid, but you want to scrape the sides real good because that's where it's not going to be as hot. It's going to be hotter in the center of this, so keep it stirring. And as it gets closer to done, you want to do it in smaller and smaller increments of heat. I'm starting to foam a little bit, which means I'm really close to scorching it. But I mix it, keep it going. I will give you one little cautionary note. When I'm not talking into a microphone, normally when I'm working on this stuff, I'm using this respirator because the fumes from this plastisol heating up will definitely, they're bad for you. So you want to keep that to a minimum by using a respirator. All right, I'm mixing this stuff up, and normally I close this mold and I put the clamps on it and I shoot it in with an injector, and I'm still going to do all that, but before I do that, I'm going to do something a little bit unusual. I'm going to hand pour with this injection mold a little bit first. The reason I'm doing this is because I've been putting rattles in these, and they slide all the way to the end to a part of the mold where it's thin, which is right back here. And then as soon as I start jerking, the bait off the bottom, that rattle, that glass rattle, kind of shoots out of there. So I don't know if this is going to work, but I'm always tinkering, trying new stuff. So I'm going to lay that. Let's see. I'm gonna lay that sucker right about there in hopes that when I shoot it, it goes around it. Yep, stick it in there a little bit. Okay, then I'll close this up, then clamp it and put my injector right there. Now I've got two clamps here for a mold this big. The 7-inch Wutzit is, I want to do it soft bait's biggest non-production mold. They have ones that are specially made for people who make and sell the baits. I guess you can use them all for that, but they have high capacity ones. This is the biggest low capacity one. Alright, so I'm drawing some up, pushing out all the air, drawing up some more, stick the nozzle down in there, and push the plunger down, and I can feel where it stops. Now, with a mold where it's, the first time you use a mold, it will, when it's cold, it'll draw in more plastic, so you want to give it a constant feed. Watch it for a couple minutes. It'll draw some more of this down in there. That will suck down in it. And if you let it do it too much, it'll suck air into the bait itself. You want to make sure that that doesn't happen. So I just keep it with a positive meniscus. I just kind of mound it up there. That way it's got extra to draw down as it needs it. We'll see here, and I'll say 120 seconds. 2 minutes from now, we'll open that sucker up and we'll see if this worked. Right. Pull these clamps off. See if we can pull this apart. And yep, there's our first batch. Rattling, glowing, and yeah, soon to be ultraviolet glowing 7-inch wotsits. All right, I'm gonna make a whole bunch more of these, and then we'll get back to our jig heads. Okay, I made 18 of these in pretty short order. And before I move on to the jig heads we just cured, I'm gonna add my secret sauce. That's this stuff here. It's UV Blast. This is probably the easiest way. And actually, before I spray that, I'm gonna set one of those aside just to show the difference, what it does. I got a black light I'll show you here in a minute, but there's actually four different ways that you can put this stuff on things, and the easiest is this spray. I'll go ahead and get both sides. If you prefer, there's a worm dip. I'm not going to open that, but you can just dip it the same way that, you know, use the worm dip to dip the tails red, or, you know, it'll put the UV on there. There is UV that we're going to use in this seal coat. Once we put the eyeballs on these jig heads, we're going to dip it in there, and it'll make it that glow. And I don't mean glow like the glow additive. It's different. It's ultraviolet light, which actually penetrates to a deeper depth than traditional light. This is UV powder paint, which we could have used, and we could have even blended into the powder paint. So there are four different options how to get this UV stuff on there. All right, I got two helpers here that are gonna show you what this stuff, the UV blast and the UV worm dip, can do to make your lures really light up. Cooper, go ahead and turn the black light on. This is just a small handheld black light.
Yeah.
All right, I pass that over. These are two lures that I made last night. One of them I treated with the UV blast, and one of them I didn't. Can you guys tell which one it is?
It looks like this one, because that one is lighter and that one is darker.
Which one is it?
This one, because that one is darker.
Yeah. All right, now let's try it with a more natural color drip fade. Cooper, put it on this one here.
Oh, what both is that?
Yeah.
Okay.
Can you tell which one has it on there?
I think it's this one, because this part is dark yellow, and that one is like light yeah. Yellow. Yeah, indeed.
Okay. Well, you can kind of see a difference there, right?
Sort of. And I can see a difference on that.
Now, I've treated these are some soft plastic jerk baits. I'm going to take this away, and they just look white, don't they?
Yeah.
All right, I'm going to take them away. And one of them I dipped in the worm dye here, and a couple of them I sprayed with the UV blast. You guys are going to tell me which one I did not treat at all. Look at them, Coop. Which one didn't I treat?
This one.
Pick it up.
Because it's right, dark.
That one wasn't treated. Now, which one was dipped in the UV?
This, because I can see like dots there.
Yeah, that one was dipped in there. And these other ones, we put the UV blast. I just sprayed it on. And if you flip them, we'll go ahead and flip them. I did not treat this side, so they look pretty dull. Let's go ahead and I'm going to have you guys dip the one that wasn't done in this.
I can't remember. Which one was it?
Please don't spill this. Dip it in there very gently, and I'll hold the light.
Thanks. Hiya, give me, please.
All right, how does that look?
Good, I didn't get the tip.
That's all right. Keep it over over this.
Keep it over, Cooper.
Otherwise, Mommy's counter's gonna glow funky.
Did the people who make this house make it glow funky.
Alright. Well, that's it. And that's what the fish see. The fish see that ultraviolet light more than we can.
Do you know what I should better do? Wash my hands or they're going to glow funky.
Okay. What do you think of that? You think that helps us catch fish?
Yeah. I wonder if you're going to catch stripe at the Chesapeake Bay with those.
Yep, that's the plan. So here are the glow-in-the-dark jig heads we made. And what we're going to do is take these oversized eyeballs, adhesive eyes, and just stick them on there. And then to kind of seal them in there, because I guarantee you the first rock that hits just stuck on there with the adhesive, it'll come right off. We're going to use the seal coat. We'll shake it up, and that's got the UV blast on it as well. That's it, the final product, a glow-in-the-dark UV blasted morsel for a striped bass. And that rattle in there, I think, is really going to be a big advantage when I have suspended striper out in the bay. I think I can rattle this jig it up and down right through the school. That's going to call them in nicely. So not just going to do some bottom bouncing with this, but I think I can fish the middle of the water column, and I can fish it deep because of the glow and the UV. Can't wait for Saturday. To order any of the tackle crafting supplies you've just seen, visit doitmolds.com.